into this new life. We have a very, very apt message for today. You know, in these times, you just, you know, turn your television on and you see news. Well, good news sometimes, but a lot of times bad news. Terrorism, destruction, diseases that are evolving, and all these viruses that are all around. And sometimes I believe that when we turn on the news, the TV, fear starts to strike in the hearts of men. But I believe this message is going to settle your heart in peace. So I want you to sit back and I want you to absorb everything that God is going to tell you today. Enjoy.
Today and in the days to come, all the more we need to know that we have divine protection that comes from heaven. Amen. With all the new viruses that are around, amen, the newest one is Zika virus and all of these things. Well, you know, it's mutating. Viruses are mutating, you know, and science and medicine is trying to catch up, all right, from these mutations. Praise God that we have protection. Amen. Praise God we have protection. Also, with regards to calamities and typhoons, and there's a talk about the great earthquake that's coming into, you know, that is poised and ready, amen, for Manila to have. Among, you know, praise God that we have divine protection. Let me say this, you can never ever be protected in your own. Where will you get protection, all right, if not from God? That is why today, our salvation comes from above. We are in the world, Jesus says, but we are not of the world. Amen. We are of heaven. Amen. And that means that our protection comes from Him, from above. Amen. Let me read some verses before Psalm 91. Jesus said in John 16, verse 33, in the Amplified, it says, I have told you these things so that in me, you may have perfect peace and confidence. Amen. In the world, you will have tribulation, trials, and distress, and frustration. Is that given? Yes. We will have definitely tribulation, trials, distress, and frustration. But for a believer, Jesus is saying, but be of good cheer. Take courage, be confident, certain, and undaunted. Why? For Jesus. For I have overcome the world, I have deprived it of power to harm you and conquered it for you. Hallelujah. Amen. He did it all for us. Amen. He did it all for us. And then, even before He went to the cross, in John 17, He prayed a prayer. Amen. Well, you know, when God, or rather Jesus prays a prayer to the Father cannot say no to Jesus. Amen. Cannot say no to Jesus. So this is the prayer. In John 17, 15 to 16, this is His prayer to you and to me today, all right? He says, I do not pray that you should take them out of the world, all right? But that you should keep them from the evil one. Wow, amen. God will keep us from the evil one. The plan of the evil one is to steal, kill, and destroy, all right? But Jesus said, I come that you might have life and life to the fullest. Amen. So let's start with Psalm 91. Psalm 91. It's a psalm of divine protection. All right? Psalm of divine protection. It says, He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Verse 2, I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge. He is my fortress, my God. In Him I will trust. In these two verses alone, God sets a foundation for our divine protection. All right? And in these two verses alone, we see that we see four names of God. All right? It's so important that God is saying, hey, your protection comes from me. All right? And here in this verse alone, He's giving to us His names. All right? Four names. All right? First, in verse 1, He who dwells in the secret place of the Most High. The word Most High or the name Most High is the Hebrew name Elyon, which means highest. Among you, there is no higher God than our God. So He is the supreme and He is the highest. All right? Shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Second name, Almighty, which is the Hebrew name El Shaddai or Shaddai, okay? Wherein it means most powerful, okay? He is the Elyon, highest, and he is El Shaddai, which means most powerful, unconquerable, all-sufficient, capable of being all that his people need. El Shaddai, El Shaddai. Amen. We have El Shaddai, all right? Capable of being all that his people need. Whatever you need God to be, he is. Amen. He is. So he is El Shaddai. Now, verse 2, I will say of the Lord. Third name. That name, Lord, in the Hebrew is Yahweh, or we get the name Jehovah, the self-existing one. All right? He's the self-existing one. That means he's the source of all. All right? So we have Most High, we have Almighty, we have the Lord, and then he is my refuge, verse 2, my fortress, my God. That name God in the Hebrew is Elohim, which means God and God alone. No other like our God. Amen. So in these two verses alone, we can see four names of God. But do you know there's the fifth name of God in Psalm 91? Where is that? We go to verse 16. So let's look at verse 16. How many of you like this promise? With long life, I will satisfy him and show him my salvation. Oh, Pastor, where is that fifth name? You know that word salvation? Get ready for this. It's the name Yeshua. Salvation in Hebrew is Yeshua, wherein we get Jesus. Among you know, in Jesus we have salvation. Amen. In Jesus we have wholeness. In Jesus we have life. In Jesus we have prosperity. In Jesus we have protection. Amen. So, interesting enough to see in Psalm 91, God is giving us his five names. You know why? Because if you study, you know, Bible and numbers, you're going to see even the numbers in the Bible has a meaning. You know, just like in number 6, you know, Adam and Eve, they were created at the sixth day. You know why 6? Because number 6 is the number of man. And God rested on the seventh day. You know why 7? Because it's a number of perfection and rest. You know why 5? God gave us 5 names because 5 in the Bible speaks of grace. You know what God is saying? Your protection is by grace. It's given. What is grace? It's God's love in action. He's giving all himself to protect you. And our part to receive grace is to receive. Our part to receive grace is to believe in his giving so that we can be under his protection. Hallelujah! Amen. So divine protection really comes from heaven. Amen. And for us, we need to access it. We need to just receive that. Amen. Now, let's continue. In verse 1 alone, verse 2, we're going to see more things. It says, he who dwells in the secret place. So, where is that secret place? God is saying, he who dwells in the secret place, in the Most High, he is going to be saved. And so, I asked that question, Holy Spirit, where is that secret place? Do you know that the Bible will give, interpret the Bible, or we will answer the Bible? Now, if you go to the Old, in the New Testament, we are now going to see the answer to where is that secret place. The answer lies in the word secret. Okay? So, let's go. Colossians 1, 26 to 27. Do you want to know where that secret place? So, this is the answer. The mystery or secret, which has been hidden from ages and from generations, but now, everybody say now, now has been revealed to us, his saints, verse 27, to them, to us, God willed to make known what are the riches of the glory of this mystery or secret among the Gentiles, which is Christ in you, the hope of glory. So this secret that was kept from generations, that is now being revealed to us, is Christ in you, the hope of glory. So let me submit this to you. that he who dwells in that secret place is actually not a place, but it is a person. Hallelujah. Amen. Are you in Christ? Amen. Our place of security, my friends, is in Jesus Christ. Amen. When we are in Christ, then we are safe. When we are in Christ, the devil cannot touch us. The moment you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, God transferred you to be in Him. And when you are in Him, the devil does not see you. The devil sees Christ in you. Amen. Christ out in the outside. Amen. Hallelujah. Just like Noah was in the ark. Was Noah saved from the flood? Was Noah saved from the calamity? Was Noah saved from the tragedy? Amen. Why? Because he was in the ark. Amen. Are you in the ark? Well, Jesus is our spiritual ark. Amen. Whatever form of calamity comes, whatever form of trial comes, whatever form of tribulation will come, hey, you are in the ark. You might be falling in the ark, but you're still in the ark. Amen. You can stand up in the ark. Doesn't really matter what happens in the outside. You are covered by the blood of Jesus. Amen. Because you are in Christ. So your secret place, my friend, is in a person. And his name is Jesus. So wherever you go, you are in that secret place. My prayer is that you understand what we have, what you have in Jesus. Amen. Your identity in the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. So that word secret is actually a covering or a shelter. Psalm 32 verse 7 says, you are my hiding place. Amen. You are my hiding place. You always fill my heart with songs of deliverance. Whenever I am afraid, I will trust in you. I will trust in you. Let the weak say, I am strong. In the strength of the Lord, I will trust in you. Amen. It's a person. His name is Jesus. Amen. You are my hiding place. You will protect me from trouble and surround me with songs of deliverance. So verse 1 says, he who dwells in the secret. Now we know the secret place is a person. His name is Jesus. You know that word dwells in verse 1? He who dwells, that word dwells is actually, the meaning of that, it means to sit down. To sit down, to settle, to remain. Now let me ask you a question. What is your position in Christ? Amen. What is your position in Christ? Well, let's go back to the Bible. And let's see in Ephesians your position in Christ. Are you ready to see your position? Amen. In verse 4 and to 7, in verse 4 to 7, chapter 2, it says, but God, who is rich in mercy, because of his great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead in trespasses, he made us what? Alive together with Christ. By grace you have been saved. Verse 6, and he raised us up together and made us what? So what is your position? Seated. All right? He made us sit together in the heavenly places in Christ. Now, get ready. Look at verse 7. That in the ages to come, while you are seated, the ages to come, and we are in that age, that he might show the exceeding riches of his grace in his kindness towards us who are seated in Christ Jesus. Amen. Are you ready for some demonstration of the grace of God in your life? Amen. So, what is your position, my friend? Seated. You know what that means? When you are seated, you're rested. Amen. Who's doing the work today? I am. Okay? You are sleeping. No, you are seated. All right? Balcony, you are seated. And you are listening attentively. Right, balcony? Dito sa kanan. Wala. Hindi. Dito sa kanan ulit. Ayun. Amen. Let's pray for the people at my right. Hallelujah. When we are seated, that means we are rested. You know why we can rest? Because Jesus has done the work. Amen. Positionally in Christ, we are seated. Now, going back to Psalm 91, verse 1 pa lang, ha? Look at this. He who is seated dwells. in the secret place. What's the secret place? Who's the secret place? In Christ. Your protection comes to you when you know that you are in Christ. Seated, understanding who you are, your identity in Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Now, that word dwell also means another thing. It means to marry. So it means to marry. All right? In the design of God, the man is designed by God to cover the woman. You know, that's a design of God. The man is there to really cover the woman. And the woman will say, the wife will say, amen. So even our build, you know, our build, okay, we are built to cover. We're macho, all right? Let's flex it, all right? We are built to cover the woman. Among you know, Jesus is our bridegroom. Amen. And we are what? The bride. And so Jesus, when he said, you are the bride, he's there to protect, he's there to nourish, he's there to take care of the bride. And you and I, the Bible says, we are the bride of Christ. Amen. So it means to dwell. Also means to marry. Amen. Because knowing when you are married, your husband is your covering. Amen. And all the women will say, amen. Amen. Your husband is your covering. Okay? Now, shall abide. That word abide. Why am I going word for word? Because for us to understand Psalm 91, we need to mine these words, all right, so that it will be true to us. Amen. It will be true to us. So it says, shall abide. Abide means to stay permanently. You know, in Christ, you are permanently in Christ. Amen. You are permanently in Him. And it says, under the shadow. That word shadow means shade or defense. When you are near the shadow of a person, that means, you know, you are in the proximity of that person. Right? So when I am in a shadow of somebody, for example, I'm near Pastor Joey, and there is a light, you know, that means the shadow of Pastor Joey will be cast, you know, towards me or upon me, right? So that means a big shadow? No, naman. All right? So what it means, it is a place of nearness. It's a closeness. Aren't you glad that we are close to God? Amen. So it's a shade and a what? A defense. All right, Psalm 121, verse 5, it says, the Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. Psalm 27, verse 5 says, for in the day of trouble, he will keep me safe in his dwelling. He will hide me in the shelter of his sacred tent and set me high upon the rock. In the New King James, he will hide me in his pavilion, and in the secret place of his tabernacle, he shall hide me. He shall set me high upon the rock. Can you see this? It's always him who's doing it. I will protect you. I will hide you. I tell you, let him hide you. Amen. Praise God. This is his psalm of protection. It's amazing. Now, let's go to verse 2. That's all verse 1. Now, in verse 2, how do we access God's protection? Amen. How do we make it personal in our everyday lives? Well, you want to know? Well, verse 2 tells us how. It says in verse 2, Psalm 91, verse 2, I will say of the Lord. So how do we access this divine protection? By speaking it. By saying it. Amen. Last Sunday, we declared that this house is shouting ground. Amen. We have a shout. We have a song. Amen. As we know who we are in Christ, victors are loud. Amen. We have something to shout about. Amen. And so the same thing, you know, when we know that we have divine protection, my friend, we need to speak it. For us to access into it, we need to speak it. Amen. Rather than saying, you know what? Achoo! It's flu season. You know, I'm going to get the flu now. This is the season that I'm going to get sick. No, my friend. No, I have divine protection in Jesus' name. Amen. Oh, you know what? My great-great-great-great father died with a heart attack. And I think I'm going to die also with a heart attack. What do you say? You're going to say no. You know, because generational curses, you know, it's broken in Jesus' name. Amen. So it's broken. So what do you say? Amen. Now, God is giving us something to say about with regards to divine protection. Oh, you know what? Earthquake. Yeah, you know. You have something to say. You can even touch the ground and say, wait, ground, listen to me. Amen. I'm a son of God. And I declare this. Amen. This ground is not going to move. Amen. You can speak it. Amen. You can declare it. I will say of the Lord. Amen. Question, what are we saying? Amen. What are we declaring? God is giving us words. Amen. And you know what's beautiful with words? The more we say it, the more we hear it. Amen. Say this. I am protected by God. Say no sickness, no disease, no accident, no calamity, no plague will touch me or my family. I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge. He is my fortress, my God, in whom I will trust. I believe it. Amen. So what are we saying? Amen. You're actually accessing divine protection. And also as you say it, you hear it. Because faith comes by hearing, not having heard. So the more you hear it, the more you say it, the more you hear it, faith rises up. The more you hear it, you speak it, the more faith comes in. And so you speak something. You know, today is going to be a good day. Next week is going to be, this week is going to be a good week. It's going to be a protected week. Amen. It's going to be a blessed week. What are we saying? Amen. We have something to say. And the Bible is very clear. The psalmist gives us words. He says, He is my refuge. He is, can you see that personal? He is my fortress. Amen. It becomes personal. My God, in Him I will trust. Amen. You know that word refuge is a shelter. It's a shelter, okay? A refuge in every time of trouble. But also, He's not just a shelter. The Bible says, the psalmist also wrote that He's also a fortress. So a fortress is a castle with walls that surround the castle. All right? So the psalmist is saying that for small and everyday challenges or attack, God is my refuge. All right? In big, you know, open attacks, you know, things that we cannot really, coming from different sides, we have God as our fortress. So we have God as our shelter. We have God as our fortress. In either case, we are protected. We can run to Him inside that shelter. We can run to Him inside that fortress. Amen. Take your pick. Wherever, you're still protected. Hallelujah. God got us covered. Amen. Amen. Now, Psalm 91, verse 3 to 4, okay? Now we understand verse 1 and 2, which is the foundation. Then now let's go to the blessings of His protection. Are you ready? It says, surely. Everybody say, surely. Surely, that means surely, man. Surely, sigurado, okay? He shall deliver you. When God says surely, hallelujah, we can rest in that. That's a sure foundation that we can stand on. Actually, today, we can go home now. Because He said, surely. Right? When He says surely, we can bank on. We can trust that word. Amen? Because He's faithful to His word. Amen? Surely He shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler. You know what is a fowler? It's a bird trapper. All right? So the devil might have traps along the way, but he can deliver you. Surely, the Bible says, surely God is able to deliver you. You know how? By giving you wisdom. There are traps along the way. Maybe there are like you're getting into a business, but there's like a scratchy feeling inside of you. But God is saying, no, don't deal with these people. They're corrupt people. Don't deal with them. All right? So God protects you from these people. Amen. Amen. He's saying, surely He shall deliver you from the snare of the fowler. And from the what? And from the perilous pestilence. And this is a trademark for Pastor Joey. Yung mga peste sa buhay nyo. Oh, don't look at your neighbor right now. Okay? These pests, all right? Pestilence. Or you could say plague. All right? And later on, the psalmist continues to say and write about plagues and pestilence. So we're going to check that out later, okay? So surely he will deliver you from the trapper. He will deliver you from the perilous pestilences. Then verse 4, he shall cover. Amen. Everybody say cover. Interesting, that word cover is to weave you in. To weave you in. So that means he will weave you in with his feathers. You know, funny, there's a story that I heard many, many years ago of an elderly woman who was held up. All right? And the robber, he was pointing a gun, you know, in an alley. And then the woman, you know, just remembered Psalm 91. But she cannot, declares the whole of Psalm 91. And you know what she declared? Feathers! 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 Well, you know, God honored that. And this is a true story. And the robber, you know, ran for whatever reason. Maybe the robber saw an angel or whatever. But this elderly woman said, feathers, feathers, feathers. Come on, you know, God will honor that. If you don't get anything today, just get feathers. All right? So he says, he shall cover you with his feathers and under his wings. Amen. His wings, you shall take refuge. Look at that. The wording says, you shall take refuge. So I searched the internet. You know, it really gives us a picture of what we have, all right? And so God is giving us an idea of our protection. So can you look at this? All right? Like a mother hen protects his chicks or her chicks. Can you see that? So nice, right? Okay, he shall cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you shall take. Everybody's trying to get inside, right? You know, that's really it. God is just, when you are in trouble or when you are in tribulation, you know what God is going to do? I saw a video, actually, of a mother hen when there's like a perpetrator that is going to come in and attack or eat or try to get the chick. You know, the mother hen will go like this and spread her wings high. And the chicks, they know they need to run to the mother hen. It's not the mother hen trying to cover all of them. No, the mother hen is in the right place, in just a stationary place, and all the chick will run to the mother hen. So everybody's running. Look. Okay? And this guy, I don't know what he's doing. Ito yung mga pasaway eh. These are those people who are sleeping in church. No, I'm just joking. But really, I'm serious. Wake up! This guy's sleeping. Hey, something's happening and you're sleeping there. Hallelujah. Amen. But isn't this a nice picture? You want to see another picture of protection? Look at that. Amen. In our high place, we're still protected. We're covered. Amen. He shall cover you with his feathers, and under his wings you shall take refuge. Amen. You shall take refuge. And then it says, his truth shall be your shield and your buckler. Amen. His truth shall be your shield and your buckler. But let me say this. You know, going back to that covering, you know, Jesus Christ for Jerusalem, even before he died. And he said, oh, Jerusalem, Jerusalem, the city that kills the prophets and stones God's messengers. How often I have wanted to gather your children together as a hen protects her chicks beneath her wings. But you would not let me. You know, it's a choice. It's really a choice for us. God says, you're here at the cross. My arms are open up and open wide. Come. It's an open invitation to everybody. Amen. But you and I need to come, need to get under the covering of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. So, his truth shall be your shield and your buckler. What is that truth? Amen. His word. Amen. Aren't you glad that you have his word? Amen. That word that is a revelation inside of you is going to be your shield. Amen. And that word shield there is actually a large shield. Okay? A door-like shield that protects you from the arrows of the enemy. Okay? And so you have the Word of God. Do you have the Word of God? Amen. Like right now, you have the Word for protection. And so this Word becomes now your shield. And whatever happens this week, this is now becomes your what? Your big shield. All right? Your large door-like shield that can cover you. But, Mong, you know, you are exposed. Right? Because that shield is only facing one area. But, Mong, you know, as you are being covered in this area, right, you are exposed in the back. So God says, you are my shield. Rather, that your truth is your shield and what? Buckler. Buckler. You know what is a buckler? A buckler is a small handheld shield. All right? So, why? So, let me give you first that picture of a big shield. Maybe we're looking at a Roman shield, an example of a shield, a door-like shield, right? That can cover a man, a grown-up man, but also a buckler. What is a buckler? That's a buckler. Okay? A small shield. So, that means, you know, and this is just my idea, when you are covered with a big shield, you know, at your back, you still have that small shield for stray arrows. So you're covered either in all areas. So that means you are surrounded by God's protection. Amen. You have a double, you know, layered protection. Amen. You have the one in front, but you have also at the back. All right? For stray arrows. So God is saying that truth that you're standing on today, His Word is your shield, and He is, and it's your, the shield is your buckler. Amen. In another translation, it says, your faithful promises are your armor and your protection. Amen. Now, verse 5 and 6. Are you still okay? Verse 5 and 6. It says, and you shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness, nor of the destruction that lays waste at noonday. So here, God is saying, at night, day, darkness, midday. Dumang, you know, it's 24/7. Your protection is 24/7. All right? I'll borrow this from Pastora Heidi. It's like Rexona. It won't let you down. Amen. Hallelujah. And you are protected from four things. Terror. Look at that. You shall not be afraid of the terror by night, nor of the arrow that flies by day. We know terror. You know, nowadays, we understand what terror means. But arrow that flies by day, do you know that arrow is something that pierces or wounds spiritually, emotionally, and physically? These attacks are intentional. When the archer is poised to release an arrow towards you, he's going to try to hit you from here to up. Why? Because all the vulnerable parts are in this area. All right? And so when the devil tries to hit you with an arrow, he's going to try to focus on your heart. On your heart. That's why God says, let not your heart be troubled. Believe in me. Amen? And so with that, God is wanting to protect you from that. Amen? From that, you know, an arrow. For example, you're just walking, you know, you're not minding anything, you're just enjoying your day, and then you hear something, and then because of what you heard, fear came in. Have you experienced that? Parang fear came in, all right? Or you're just talking to somebody, and then it hit a nerve that caused you to think about the past. That's an arrow, all right? That's why it's so important that we have that shield. Amen. Because that truth is going to what? That truth is going to negate the power of that arrow. Amen. It's going to actually, you know, protect you from that arrow. Just for example, if you heard about the past, you know, something like an arrow teach, you know, tries to hit you, and you heard about what happened in the past, and it's like the past was relived. Now you understand, you have the Word, okay, to tell you, wait a minute, God has redeemed me from my past. Amen. And my past will not dictate my future. I'm a new creation. Everything will be new to me right now. Amen. So now you can declare that I am loved by God. I'm the righteousness of God and all of these things. Hallelujah. And so these arrows, you know what? They're not going to be, amen, it's going to just fall down. It's not going to create a impact in your life. Amen? Because you have a protection that comes from Him. Amen? Pestilences. The Bible says here, nor of the arrow that flies by day, nor of the pestilence that walks in darkness. Pestilences are plagues, viruses, bacteria, diseases. And then destructions. Amen? At noonday. All right? Destructions are calamities, earthquakes, tsunamis, all these things that we're seeing. Aren't you noticing that even the typhoons are getting stronger and stronger? Today, we have what we call super typhoons. Before, we didn't have that. You know why? Because the earth is groaning. You know, the consequences of the curse is being felt like never before. That's why this is a time wherein the church needs to continue to get brighter. As the world gets darker, the church needs to get brighter. Amen. And all the people say, amen. Now, verse 7 and 8. 1,000 may fall at your side and 10,000 at your right hand, but it shall not come near you. Amen. Only with your eyes you shall look and see the reward of the wicked. You know, in Exodus, the Hebrews, they were protected supernaturally by God, right? They were in a place called Goshen. Goshen. And Goshen means drawing near. All right? God put them in this place of drawing near. Do you know we are in our spiritual Goshen? Wherein God put us in a place in Christ. That is our place of drawing near. Now, in the place of Goshen, all the plagues are happening. But in Goshen, God's protecting this supernatural place. This place supernaturally. Amen. Let me give you a picture. Exodus 8, 22 to 23. And in that day, I will set apart the land of Goshen in which my people dwell, that no swarms of flies shall be there, in order that you may know that I am the Lord in the midst of the land. I will make a what? A difference. Everybody say a difference. Do you know that word difference is actually to set a ransom? To set a ransom. So that means Jesus has ransomed us. Amen. It's as if God is saying, I ransom you, you are already mine. No one can touch you. You are mine. So a difference means I have ransomed you. I set a ransom. And he says, for the Israelites, I will make a difference between my people and your people. Tomorrow, this sign shall be. Amen. Do you know that flies carry sickness and disease? Right? Flies carry sickness and disease. And in this plague, there will be what? Swarms of flies that will be there in Egypt, but not in Goshen. God is saying to you and me that God has redeemed us from sickness and disease. Amen. It should not touch us. It should have no access in your body. Amen. In Jesus' name. Right? Exodus 9:4. And the Lord will make a... Everybody say difference. I have ransomed you. Look at this. Between the livestock of Israel and the livestock of Egypt, so nothing shall die of all that belongs to the children of Israel. You know, livestock means your possession. Livestock means your career. Amen. Livestock means your job. It's your means or your livelihood. So God is saying, I will make a difference between the livelihood of the people of God, my people, and the people of the world. Amen. You know why? Because God has ransomed you from poverty. Hallelujah. Amen. God has ransomed you from poverty. Amen. He became poor so that you and I could become rich in Him. Hallelujah. So God wants to make that difference. Amen. Amen. And verse 11, chapter 11, verse 6 to 7. Then there, and this is the last plague, and then there shall be a great cry throughout the land of Egypt, such as was not like it before, nor shall be like it again. But against none of the children of Israel shall a dog move its tongue, against man or beast, that you may know that the Lord does make a difference between the Egyptians and Israel. Hallelujah. Amen. You know, God has ransomed us from death. Amen. God paid for so that today we will have eternal life. Amen. And now death for us is only going to be a transfer. Amen. To a better place. Do you know in our, the number three prayer requests of many people, the top three prayer requests of many people is this: healing, provision, and, you know, that they are going to be redeemed or they're going to be protected from death. Among, you know, Jesus made a difference so that you and I could be protected. Amen. You and I could be redeemed from poverty, and you and I could be free from sickness and disease. Hallelujah. God wants to make a difference. And I believe in these last days it's going to be so. Let me hear you. Let me hear you say amen to that. Because that is the position of the body of Christ. Amen. The path of the just shines brighter and brighter and brighter until the perfect day. Amen. Because you know why? Because God wants to make a startling difference. Amen. The world will see God's protection and God's favor upon the church. Because they're going to see, why do you have that? And we're going to point them to Jesus. Amen. Verse 9 and 10. Because you have made the Lord, who is my refuge, even the Most High, your dwelling place, no evil shall befall you, nor shall any plague come near your dwelling. What is your dwelling? Your family. Your house. Amen. Halfway in the psalm, verse 9 repeats our connection to divine protection. Because you have made the Lord. Amen. You have made the Lord. And how do you make the Lord your dwelling place? By saying it. By declaring it. Amen. So there will be no plague. Plague means infliction in the body. Disease, sickness, and diseases, amen, shall not come or touch or even prosper in your life and in your family. Isn't this good news? Amen. Let's continue. Verse 11 to 13. For he shall give his angels charge over you to keep you in all your ways. Hallelujah. In their hands they shall bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. Hallelujah. Do you know angels are there to minister to you and I? We have a song that angels cannot sing. Angels are created beings, but you and I, we are redeemed. So angels, they're not there to be worshipped. They're amazing beings, amen? They're glorious, but I tell you, they're there to minister to you and to me. And I'm here to tell you, there will be heightened angelic ministries in these last days. You're going to see it. I'm going to see it. Maybe we're not going to see it with our naked eye, but I tell you, you're going to be aware. Whoa. I have been touched by an angel. Amen. There is going to be something that you're going to attribute it. It's just supernatural protection. You know, there was a story of a Christian. You know, at that time, he was in this hotel in Bali. All right? And he was in the lobby. And, you know, as he was in the lobby, he was just walking. And there was this big column or post. All right? A column that he just, at that right time, he just passed by, and then the bomb blew off. And he was not hurt because the column saved him from the effects of the bomb in the lobby in Bali. Among, you know, that's supernatural. How will you know that there's a bomb going to blow up? I need to pass this. You know, how will you know that? It's only divine protection, my friend. It happened in the Bible, and it's still happening now. There are many angels around here. And look at this. The Bible says angels. Not just an angel. All right? Angel is good. One angel in the Bible killed 100,000 enemies. One angel. You have angels. Amen. Angels. Angels watching over me. Amen. Angels watching over you. Amen. Hallelujah. Verse 13. You shall tread upon the lion and the cobra. The young lion, the serpent, you shall trample underfoot. Amen. What is a lion? What is a cobra? A lion, both lion and cobras. Lions are, you could see, lion is there. You will know that the lion will be there and ready to attack you, right? So these are open attacks. These are violent attacks. But cobras, they are in secret. They're subtle. You won't know that they're there. You won't know that people are conniving and teaching and thinking about these things to pull you down, all right? And all these things. And so the serpent, you know, all secret, you know, and the malignant ones, the things that you cannot see, these are the attacks like cobras, all right? So even in the big attacks, the open attacks, or in the secret attacks, God's angels are there to protect you. Amen. You are preserved from both evil, open or secret attacks. Amen. And so, let's continue. Okay? Are you still okay? Amen. In the Bible, there's many, many instances of divine protection. One thing that I like, you know, when I read Daniel, all right? Angels, angelic activities. He was put in a lion's den, and the lions, they were so hungry, but the angels, you know, cannot, you know, protected Daniel from being eaten by the lions. Amen. Mang, you know, if that happened in the Old Testament, how much more in the New? Amen. If that happened before Jesus died at the cross, how much more today that his blood was spilled for you and for me? Hallelujah! Get ready, amen, to see more of that in the days to come. Amen. Hallelujah. So let's continue. Psalm 91, verse 14 to 16. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. Amen. In the Hebrew, that phrase, because he has set his love upon me, it says has become attracted or attached to me. Attached to me. Has united himself with me. In the Hebrew, the word expresses the strongest attachment ever. Right? And it's equivalent to our expression to fall in love with him. Alright? To fall in love. Among you know, the reason why we can say he has set his love upon me, God is saying that he has set his love upon me, is because he has loved us first. We love because he first loved us. Amen. We receive his love, then we can respond with our loving. Amen. And also, here in this verse, you know, from a third person talking about God's promises of protection, it shifts to a first person. Now God is beginning to say these things, you know, to us. All right? It says, because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will what? Deliver him. That word deliver means to bring you into safety. All right? I will set him on high. He will put you at the highest that nothing can touch you. Amen? Because he has known my name. Among you know that he's doing that. Why? What did we do? We responded to his love. Amen? Verse 15, it says, he shall call upon me. Amen? You can call upon the Lord. And, among you know, that's actually a place of humility. Wherein you're saying, Lord, this week, I need you. Among you know, that's the most powerful place to be. Because that's where God's grace now begins to move. Amen. When you are in this place of humility, the Bible says God resists the proud, but he gives grace to the humble. Amen. So when you call upon me, God is saying, he shall call upon me and I will what? I will answer. You need to expect an answer every time you call upon God. Amen. Because he says, when you call, I will answer. I will be with him in trouble. You know, I remember Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. This story, they were put in a fiery furnace, 7 times hotter. And the king was looking at these 3 men, right? Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. But inside that furnace, you know, that king saw another man. All right? While they were inside the furnace that was meant to kill them, you know, in the furnace, it's as if nothing was happening to them. You know why? Because there was another man. And the king said, look, there's another man. And he looks like a son of God. Among you know, that's Jesus. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you are with me. Amen. You know, he says, I will be with him in trouble. We call upon him, and he will be with us. Aren't you glad we're just going to go through that? There are times we overcome. There are times, God prevents us from taking that route. Or sometimes you go through that route, but he's going to be there. Amen. He's going to be in there with you in trouble. Amen. Verse 15 says, I will call upon him. And it says, I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. And I will what? Now, that word deliver is exciting. Okay? Because that word deliver is actually, it means means to remove or to equip. All right? So it means to remove, draw out, draw off, all right, take off, withdraw, or to equip you for war. So thus, God is saying, I will save him from trouble, from danger, or equip him with everything needed to overcome any challenges. Amen. So as you go through that, you know, you're going to be equipped to overcome that trouble. Amen. Amen. Are you still okay? So it says, I will deliver him. We call upon him. I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him and I will honor him. Amen. I don't know about you, but when God honors you, amen, God is just going to open up doors that no man cannot shut. Amen. I don't know about you, but when God begins to honor a person of favor, people are just going to try to stop you, but you cannot be stopped. Because the force of heaven is going to be with you. Amen. You're honored by God. You're favored by God. You're going to be seeing amazing things in your life. Amen. Just like, you know, just like the people of old. They've saw the favor of God upon their life. I believe this day and in the days to come, there will be heightened movement wherein God is going to position you supernaturally. Amen. For the purpose of the kingdom. Because you carry his heart. And you know what? There's a contract that needs to be signed. And you know what? There will be nothing that can stop you from signing that contract. Amen. For that money to come in, there will be opportunities for that money to come in. Amen. You know why? Because it must be so. Because when God honors you, doesn't really matter if man honors you. Man can honor you, praise God. That's a bonus. But I tell you, when God honors you, man can't do anything. Amen. I would rather be honored by heaven than by earth. Hallelujah. Amen. So get ready for that, church. Because there will be honoring that is happening. Amen. As we humble ourselves in the sight of God, there will be an honoring. Amen. These are bonus blessings here at Psalm 91. And then my favorite, verse 16. With what? Among you like this. With long life, I will satisfy him. You know what is long life? A long life is a satisfied life. It's not just in quality, not just in quantity or length of days. It is actually in quality. Amen. God wants you to have both. God wants you to have a quality of life, a quantity of life. Amen. That you're going to live satisfied until that day wherein you say, Lord, I have kept the faith. I've finished the race. I'm ready to go home. I am satisfied. Hallelujah. That is long life, my friend. And God is giving that to you and to me, that you will be satisfied with this life. In this life, that you have fulfilled everything that God has destined you to do by his grace. Amen. And you come into that place wherein, Lord, I'm done. I'm ready. Amen. And not, amen. Mom, you want to be in that place. Amen. With long life. Everybody say long life.
Long life.
Amen. Mom, you want that? And it says, and with long life, I will satisfy him and show him my. Look at the wordings here. How are you going to be satisfied? How are you going to satisfy? The world is not going to satisfy you. Only Jesus can satisfy you. And the psalmist is saying, God is saying, and I will show him my Yeshua. The more you see Yeshua, the more you understand that there's nothing like Yeshua. The world might have a lot, but in Jesus, you will have everything. Amen. In Jesus, you're going to find fulfillment. In Jesus, you're going to find satisfaction. In Jesus, you have wholeness. Amen.
Wasn't that a powerful word? God wants to protect you. That is his promise, and it is all by his grace. You don't have to work for it. You don't have to try to, you know, achieve it. All you have to do is receive the promises of God for you. Psalm 91 is such a powerful, powerful word. And I believe that as you receive that today, you are going to walk in 24/7 protection all the days of your life. But you know what? Your safety place is in a person, and that is the Lord Jesus Christ. So if you have not received him into your heart as Lord and Savior, if you're not sure that you are in that secret place, well, it would be my honor to lead you today in a prayer to receive Jesus into your heart. So let's pray. Father, thank you for sending Jesus. Thank you that you've sent our security, our sure foundation during this time of evil. I thank you that Jesus came down to pour out his love for all of us here today. And so, Father, I declare in the name of Jesus that today I receive him into my heart as my personal Lord and Savior. I acknowledge that he is my protector, he is my deliverer, and he is my rescuer. From this day on, I walk in eternal life and in divine protection because I know that Jesus loves me. So, Father, thank you for Jesus, and thank you that today I am now a child of God. I thank you for your great love for me, and I pray this in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Wonderful. You are now a child of the Most High God. So God bless you and enjoy your life.